How familiar are you with Excel's cell modes? I didn't even know this was a thing until I realized Excel behaves in a different way when I'm in a certain dialog box. So for example, if I'm in a data validation dialog box and I'd like to move around with the keyboard keys in the dialog box, it automatically inserts a cell reference in there. That's because I'm in point mode in Excel, which is different to edit mode. So what type of modes do we have and how can we switch between these modes? Let's find out. The default cell mode state for Excel, or let's say the normal state, is the ready mode. And that's what you can see here on the bottom left-hand side. Now, in this state, nothing happens. You can click on a cell, move around, click on these dialog boxes, you'll stay in ready mode. Now, the moment you start to input something, so let's say I input a number here, I go into enter mode. Because I didn't start this input with an equal sign or a plus sign or a minus sign, Excel knows that I'm not inputting a formula. So if I use now the arrow keys to move around, it's actually going to leave the cell and input that number in the cell. So if I go here and again input, let's say 60, I'm in enter mode, I either click enter or use the down arrow key and I move down a cell. But it's going to behave differently now when it sees that I'm inputting a formula. So I'm going to start with the equal sign, I'm back in enter mode, but this time I'm going to use the arrow keys again. I'm going to go up and notice which mode I'm in now. It's in point mode. So it switched directly from enter mode to point mode the moment I use the arrows. And it's only because it realized that I'm inputting a formula because I started the input with an equal sign. Now, even if you start with the minus sign or a plus sign, it's going to act the same way. So now let's say I click on the 50, I'm going to do a plus, and again, I'm in enter mode. So I'm going to go and use my arrow keys again and go and select the 60 and now press enter. And I'm back in ready mode. Okay, so I managed to switch from enter mode to point mode by using the arrow keys because I was inputting a formula. But now let's say I want to go and edit this. And let's actually try and include a new number. So I'm going to put 30 in here. Now to edit this, I'm going to use the F2 shortcut key, or you can also double click in the cell. Now we're in edit mode. That's different to the enter mode, because in edit mode, we can use the arrow keys to move around inside the formula and make changes if we wanted to. So I can switch this to a minus and I'm still in edit mode. And let's go and now add something to it. So from edit mode, now if I want to go and use my keyboard keys to select B2, I can't just press the up key right now, because what happens if I do that, it just jumps to here. Right? If I click up, it just jumps to the beginning. So I need to go back to that point mode. That's when I can use F2 key again. Now I'm in enter mode and now I can move up because it's realized that I'm editing a formula. To switch back to edit mode, I'm going to click on F2 again and I can go and switch between these two modes as much as I need. Just remember that from edit mode, you can't use the arrow keys to switch another cell. You have to click F2 again to go back to enter mode so that you can go and make your cell selection. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to edit mode and delete that last entry and press enter. Always take a look on the bottom to see which mode you're in. Now, the part that can get quite frustrating is when you're inside dialog boxes like conditional formatting, or data validation, or the name manager in formulas, or even if you're adjusting a chart range. So in the data tab here, I have just some sample data. And on this side, I have a conditional formatting rule. So let's just go and check it out. Let's go to edit rule. That's the rule. It's just looking at cell F5, checking if it's less than G5, and then it's formatting this cell to an orange color. Now, let's say I wanted to update this. What happens now if I use the arrow keys? Take a look at my status bar. I'm in enter mode and there's an equal sign in front of this. So the moment I start to move around, it's going to go to point mode because it's thinking that I want to reference a cell. But that's not what I want to do. I want to actually edit this. I want to adjust the cell reference. So I need to click on F2 to go to edit mode. Now, let's say at this point, I actually want to go and reference the cell. From edit mode, I want to switch to point mode. So I have to click on F2 again. So I go to enter mode. And now Excel realizes that because I'm in enter mode and I'm writing a formula, if I want to use the arrow keys, it's going to show that cell reference. So I'm going to go and select this. And now let's say I want to delete the dollar sign beside the 5. I need to go to edit mode. So I'm going to click on F2 again. The status changes to edit. Now I can move around with the arrow keys, delete this, and press enter. Now in this case, I'm just going to press escape because I don't want to change that formula. Okay, so just remember, whenever you go to these dialog boxes, if you don't want Excel to go to point mode, click on F2 so you go to edit mode. Now the same is true if you're creating data validation lists. So if I create a list that's, let's say, referencing this, and now I want to go and adjust this, if I click on the arrow keys, I'm in point mode. I need to click on F2 to go to edit mode. So now I'm going to click on F2, I'm in edit mode, and now I can move around. Okay, so anytime you are going to any of these dialog boxes and you want to make an adjustment, click on F2 to go to edit mode and then move around. This is going to save you from a lot of headaches. In case you don't see the status bar here, it might be disabled for you. So just right mouse click here and all the way on top, you see the cell mode. If you click it, it's a toggle. It will disappear from the bottom. Now it's gone. If I click it again, then I can see the cell mode on the bottom. So those are Excel's different cell modes. Keep an eye on which mode you're in and switch them if you need to. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's a basic one, but it's just something that's easy to miss. If you did enjoy it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you aren't subscribed to this channel. I'm going to see you in next week's video.